Hello everybody, this is Dimitrios, and for this video I would like to address the first steps that you should take as a total beginner learning the guitar. Number one is guitar posture and anchoring. You need to be able to place the guitar on your lap in a way that is comfortable and logical. There are three main ways to hold the guitar. The first one comes from the classical world, and you are placing the body of the guitar on your left leg, just like you see here. The second and third way derives from the Hispanic tradition, and specifically flamenco. And in both of those ways, you are placing the body of the guitar on your right leg, just like this. And just like this. In any case, the inner part of your forearm, this part right here, needs to be anchored on the body of the guitar, like so. We are using anchoring in order for our hand to not wander off uncontrollably. When you have your posture down, you'll want to start playing something. That brings us to step number two. What to play? The answer to that is two things. The first one is the fundamental scale, which is C major. We need to play the scale to the open position. We call the position open because for some of the notes of the scale, we are not using only our fretting hand, but also open strings. Let me demonstrate. The second thing that we need to play is what we call the open position chords. Similarly, we call those chords open position because some of the notes that are needed for the chord are open strings as well. Let me demonstrate a couple of open chords. Now that we have established our posture and what to play, we need to move to step number three, which is how. The how refers to three things: the left hand finger positioning, the right hand picking motions, and the rhythmical approach that we're going to use. Starting with the left hand fingerings, just like I'm showing you here, each finger corresponds to a fret. So the C major scale should start from the 5th string 3rd fret using our ring finger. For our right hand, we need to pick the note with a downstroke. The next note of our C major scale is D, and we can find it in the 4th open string of our guitar. We need to pick that string with an upstroke. Staying on the same string, we are moving to the next note, which is E. And we are finding that note on the 2nd fret of the 4th string, and we are pressing that note with our middle finger and using a downstroke on our right hand, just like this. Next one is going to be F, which again is the 4th string on the 3rd fret, and we are fretting it with our ring finger and an upstroke on our right hand. Moving on, we are playing the note G, which is the third string of the guitar open, so no fretting hand needed. On this note, we are using a downstroke on our right hand. Next note is A. A is on the second fret of our open G string. We need to fret it with our middle finger and use an upstroke on our right hand. After that, we are moving to the note B. Note B is the second string of our guitar open, so no fretting required. On our right hand, we are going to use a downstroke. And finally, we are returning to our bass, note C, one octave higher. We can find the note, that note C on the first fret of the second string of our guitar. Finally, we covered the C major scale and the fingerings for it. At this time, I would like to introduce you to a helpful tool that we call the metronome. This is just a tool that keeps us in the correct time. Let me show you how to use it. Now, the metronome clicks. What we need to do is to align the notes we play with the click that we hear. Let's try and do that. By playing on the metronome clicks, you played something that we call quarter notes. And what quarter notes are, you're going to ask? Let's take as an example a cup of coffee. Coffee, please. Thank you. Now, if a whole cup of coffee, okay, is a whole measure, right? Now, we divide the contents of this cup on four equal measures. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? So, we are having four quarters. Every time you are drinking from your cup, okay, let's assume that you're drinking one quarter. So, in order to finish that, you will need to take four sips. And the content of the coffee is gonna empty. Okay, so those are the quarter notes. In order to fill up one measure, okay, we took and divided the measure by four. It's that simple. Of course, you can divide the whole measure into less or more parts. Like you can just drink the whole cup. Or you can drink it in two equal sips. Or in eight. Or in 16. But the fundamental division of time is when we are breaking the measure in four equal parts. Now let's try our scale on all basic rhythmic divisions of a measure. Start at the metronome and let's do the divisions. First are the quarter notes, okay? Now, let's try 2 notes per beat. So, eighths. Very good. Let's try 1 note every 2 beats. So, halves. Very good. Now, let's try 4 notes per 1 beat. That's the hard part. Okay, it's quite fast. There are more divisions. Let me stop that. There are more divisions. Okay, like 3 notes per 1 beat, 6 notes per 1 beat, 5 notes per 1 beat. There are a lot of divisions, you know, in music. But those are more advanced. You can keep practicing on those and gradually, you're gonna get there and practice all the rest. But start from those and work your way up. For the next video, we're gonna explain the open position chords and the simple harmony and strumming of those chords. Thank you very much for being here. If you like this video, please hit like button, share it on social media, subscribe to my channel for more guitar related videos, it's absolutely free, follow me on my social media, and if you like to support me, consider becoming a patron, so I can continue to make more videos like this. Again, thank you very much, be safe out there, and see you on the next one.